And now it's time once again for the Chao Emperor's favorite program. It's Chao Easy 2020 with Week 14's action. Here is your host, Brandon Channings. And only fans and all, well, here we go again. Grab a seat on your couch or your computer decks and cheer on all your favorite superstars on a continuing quest to become the next great champion of the Chao Racing Universe. We're gonna pause for a quick commercial break and then we'll get ready for our first race of the day. Stay tuned, there's more family coming up. Chao Racing 2020 is brought to you by Orida, Potato Stunt Pepsi since 1952, and by Pepsi, the soft drink choice for every generation. Alright, let's start our Week 14's Men's Division play. And for this first race, we have Ricky Nelson, Corey Sanchester, Dallas Gamano, and Sonny Brantley. All races are being held on the Emerald Course like we always do. And here's a look at the lineup for the first race of the week. So, it's good luck to our first four competitors for Week 14's Men's Division action. Everyone is on the clock, and please start the race! Here we go! With the first race of Week 14's Men's Division action, as the first four competitors making their way towards the palm trees. And now they're gonna shake the palm trees to bring down that coconut shaped fruit on this beautiful sunny November day. A little bit chilly, but they don't mind the weather no matter how it is. And right now they're gonna eat the fruit, and there goes Ricky Nelson. He is gonna have command really up in the front. And look at that. He is going to have the upper hand of the four superstars because the other three diva superstars are dancing to the beat. And it looks like Ricky Nelson is going to be heading for the water. Stars to Master Gamano will start the speed bus for Week 14's Chao Racing 2020 action. And number one was pausing for one. Sonny Brantley and the four Silver Chao are doing their best to stay alive in the competition over at the bridges. As Sonny Brantley, the fanfare newcomer, will take speed number 2, always getting stuck in traffic behind 3 in the Silver Chao. Wolfie feels funny, alright. Anyway, Ricky Nelson has a commanding lead over Corey Sanchester. As number 1, who will pass number 2, who's paused for 1, will have the next command SPS. Now he'll have the right to catch up with Sonny Brantley for 6th place. Right now in 2nd place, it is Corey Sanchester, followed by Dallas Master Gamano in 3rd place. We are past the 1-minute mark as the next BS win made by number 8, who's doing his best to defend the lead over the 4 Silver Chao. And right now, Sonny Brantley is getting left behind still. And poor number 2 is singing the last place blues, trying to survive it back. And it looks like number 7 was positive for 1. So now here we have the joint number 2 for dear life. We'll get the next command SPS. It's that fan famous Sonny Brantley that makes his 2nd speed bus to the race. Meanwhile, Ricky Nelson is starting to have company. Corey Sanchester is finally catching up to them as they begin to climb up the storm wall. Dallas Master Gamano also doing his best to stay alive. Ooh, the competition is heating up. And this time, Sonny Brantley goes for consecutive. And he really needed his help because he was stranded in last place. And look at this, Ricky Nelson is going to rest. That means Corey Sanchester will now have command lead. Dallas and Master Gamano will have to push to move up to 2nd place. So now Ricky Nelson will need to have a little bit of catching up to do. He wants to stay alive. Next PS belongs to number 8. That makes it 2nd speed bus amaze. And he gets a sign out to the 4th Silver Chao and Sonny Brantley. Sonny Brantley and a couple of Silver Chao numbers 1 2 to be assigned are all going to rest. Oh well, there's always next time for Sonny Brantley. And it looks like number 7, who was going to mess, takes the next command SPS. He makes it meanly. And Corey Sanchester is going to get the first win of Week 14's action. Yes, sirree! Corey Sanchester is the first winner of Week 14's Men's Mission play. That's going to be followed by Dallas and Master Gamano in 2nd place. And Ricky Nelson will have to take 3rd place. Good race, everybody! And right now, who will get the next command SPS? It's number 2, who's catching up to number 7 for 5th place. Sonny Brantley at number 1 are just trying to finish out the race behind numbers 2 and 7. We should have one more speed bus before the race is over. And Sonny Brantley will get his 4th speed bus as the race comes to a close. Alright, so Corey Sanchester is now jumps to 7 wins of his 2020 season. That's right, he was a better man and thus he does deserve it wonderfully. Lots more fun after this announcement, stay tuned! Alright, welcome back from our commercial break. Let's move on to race number two. Race number two features Jerry Lang, Frank Fornataro, Antonio Bennett of the Classic Go-Getters, and Danielle Heaton. Frank Fornataro made it 2 wins in a row on last week's Week 13 Action Race, and he's pretty confident of desperately getting wins for the entire year this season. So let's see if he can make it 3 wins in a row. The other 3 superstars trying their best thing out of the game. Good luck to these players on the quest for victory, and let's have a Jerry Race! Okay, Jerry, Frank, Antonio, and Danielle are off and running for the second race of Week 14's Men's Mission Action. And right now on the 4-inch, I'm going to cheat the palm trees, bring down that cooking and cheap food. And it looks like Jerry Lang was possibly more. The other 3 child going to eat the food. And there goes Danielle, Antonio, and Frank. They're going to be battling with number 7 formerly up in the very front. As number 2 will start the speed race for this race. He is going to be heading for the water. And I think a couple of switch out on going to rest. Numbers 1 and 7 to be exact. That means Jerry Lang will have a little bit of catching up to do in the early run. At speed race number 2 in this race, we're made by number 8, who also went to rest for the count 1. Now he is stranded in last place. Right now, Antonio Bennett, the next generation superstar of Chao Racing, has a commanding lead over Danielle Heaton, as Jerry Lang will have the next curse, yes, but I don't think he's going to fly over the bridges, nope. Danielle Heaton currently sitting in 2nd place. He's doing his best to catch up with our leader, Antonio Bennett. We are approaching the 1-minute mark pretty soon. Good race so far by these competitors as we head back into Jerry Lang. That's back-to-back appearance for Jerry Lang. And number 1 toss for 1. Both he and number 8 are getting left behind the competition. They really need some speed as they want to catch up with the crowd in a hurry. But back to Jerry Lang. Now that's 3 in a row for Jerry Lang to come win. Oh well, let's just say he has a lot of fun. Meanwhile, Antonio Bennett is still trying to defend the lead over Danielle Heaton. Will he hold on for the easy victory, or will Danielle Heaton find the open hole? We'll find out soon enough. Next BS belongs to number 2, who leads over the 4th to a Chao in 4th place. But now I do believe it's time for either number 1 or number 8 to get some speed rest. Which one of them is going to get that chance? It's number 1 who gets it. So he will be pouring number 8 in the dust. And Antonio Bennett and Danielle here are going to rest. And so it's Frank Fornataro. Antonio and Danielle are making their way past the waterfall as they make their way towards the home stretch. And here comes Danielle Heaton with the next command of speed bus, trying to make a statement in the early run. Meanwhile, Jerry and Frank are battling with number 2 for third place. They don't want to be left out of the competition. And number 1 will get another turn. That makes it 2nd speed bus of the race. Antonio Bennett defending the lead over Danielle Heaton, trying to wrap things up as they make their way towards the goal line. And Danielle Heaton with another speed rest, but Antonio Bennett is going to hold on for the win. Antonio Bennett prevents Danielle Heaton from making the last second statement at the home stretch. What a deal. Number 8 can just forget about this race. So, despite one last effort by Danielle Heaton at the goal line, Antonio Bennett makes his third win of his 2020 season today. That's right. Coming up, we got more as I catch for you, but first, have a look at this. Okay, Paul, who do we have for race number 3? Race number 3 is going to feature the Mexican Ricardo Cayman, Chris Schneider of the Classic Go-Getters, Willingson, and the 2018 World Champion Donald Rennings. Ricardo Cayman has 6 wins currently up on his sleeve, hoping that this week will be another successful race for him. Let's find out if he will get another victory towards fulfilling his Cinderella season. Everyone is on the clock, and let's rock this place! Alright, the Mexican fans from their homes are going to root for Ricardo Cayman. He is already at the palm trees, bringing out that coconut sheet fruit. And Donald Rennings is going to rest. Yep, Ricardo came in seeing the food, and there he goes. He is going to say adios to the other competitors in a flash. Right now, Willingson and Krishna are going to eat the food, And there goes Will Winks, and he's going to have second place. And that's going to be followed by Chris Schneider in third place. But they have a long way to go. They want to catch up with Carl Kim's incredible speed. As the first superstar to get his speed best is Donald Vennings. Desperately trying to catch up after going west. Right now, there goes Ricardo Kamen, trying to not let anyone steal his lead. He wants to get one step closer to fulfilling his Cinderella season this year. As number 7, West Beavis number 2, as he flies towards water. Number 1 and number 2 are currently battling for D life for 7th place, all the way in the back attack. Try to catch up with number 7 as they exit the bridges. And it will be number 2 who will get the next command speed rest. We are approaching the 1 minute mark, and so far the Mexican fans are showing happy with Ricardo Kimen's performance this week, as always. As we head back into number 2, still battling in the most 174 deal life. Right now, it is Willingson, who is going in second place behind our leader, Ricardo Kamen, trying desperately to catch him on the ground. And number 2 gets a third consecutive speed bus. Meanwhile, Donald Vennings and Chris Schneider are battling for third place behind Willingson as they enter the stall wall. It's going to be Donald Vennings who will get another turn. That makes his second speed bus in the race. And poor number 1 and poor number 7 are getting left behind from number 2. Which one's going to get a chance? It's number 1 who will get the next command speed bus. And Ricardo came in as the first supposed home stretch. I don't think Will Winkson will have enough fly power to catch up to Ricardo Kamen. Yep, there's always another time for Will Winkson. Ricardo Kamen's going to get the job done. Next BS belongs to number 8, who leads over the 4th Switch Chao with 4th place. And Ricardo Kamen's going to celebrate away, away! Ricardo Kamen gets the job done once again! He beats out Will Winkson and Dominics, who will come in 2nd and 3rd places respectively. So he gets his 7th win of his Cinderella season today. As number 2, while in the next game SPS making his 4th speed buzz, he and number 7 are getting left behind in competition. And we have just enough time for one more speed buzz, and it will be made by Chris Schneider. So, congratulations to Ricardo Kamen on a successful victory. That's right, and we'll find out who will prevail in this next race after we find out what from this message. Well, the holidays are coming up soon, and hopefully everyone will stay safe during the holiday season. Right now, let's hear what Paul has to say about race number 4. Thank you, Brandon. And race number 4 will feature Jeff Nowis, Nolan Helms, Samuel Davisburg, and Kenny Days. So there's looking to line up for this next portion of the Men's Division Show. So far, so good for these superstars. Let's keep it up with this next race. We start the race! Okay, so Jeff, Nolan, Samuel, and Kenny are up next on the Men's Division schedule. Samuel and Kenny did very well securing the victories in last week's Week 13 action. Right now, let's see how well they'll do in this race. Right on the 4th, Chao gonna shake the palm trees, and right now they're cooking that cheap fruit, and now they're gonna eat fruit. And there goes Jeff Nowis and Samuel Davisburg. These two Chao will be bowing formally up in the front. The other two Chao, Nolan Helms and Kenny Days, are dancing to the beat. As number 1, who's already gained the edge on the 4th Super Chao, wins the Utahs, and guess what, fans? Jeff Nowis has taken a shortcut, so now he is going to have command the lead over the 4 competitors by now. Race Rights on Robot, uh-oh! Look who else has taken a shortcut! It's Nolan Helms! He might spoil Jeff Nowis' domination so far! Will scenario now happen as Kenny Days will take speed bus number 2. I thought Jeff Nowis was going to have an easy win, but now it looks like he has to deal with Nolan Helms after he took a shortcut joining with Jeff Nowis on the top of the hill. Nolan Helms will now have to fight the battle with Jeff Nowis over at the shortcut up in the front as they make their way towards the stone wall. As we head back into Kenny Days, he was fortunate enough to earn the victory last week, but it will be a miracle to catch up to the other two competitors in a hurry. And we are past the 1 minute mark as Sarah Naysburg is trying to catch up with Kenny Nays in a battle for third place. They are making their way towards the satisfying portion of the game, of course, and down goes Kenny Nays from the count, as number 2 will have in the next command, because he is going to lead number 8 in the nuts for the count moment. Meanwhile, Jeff Nellis and Nolan Helms are climbing up the stone wall, and here comes Jeff Nellis reaching the top of the stone wall, and he is going to rest. That means Nolan Helms will have command lead, see? I knew Nolan Helms would find the open hole. Let's see if he'll keep it up. Next piece belongs to Samuel Davisburg, and poor number 8 is seeing the last place blues all the way in the back of the pack. He's going to need a couple of speed runs if he wants to get back in this one. And this is the first of them. I think he needs a lot more help than that. And Nolan Helms, yup, he has defended the lead over Jeff Nellis. Jeff Nellis trying to make a Miyoko Valley to get back the lead from Nolan Helms. But as Samuel Davisburg takes 10 seconds speed runs, Nolan Helms is going to celebrate. Nolan Helms holds on Jeff Nellis for the victory. They both took a shortcut, but Nolan Helms made a pass with Jeff Nellis when he was going to rest. And he holds on for the victory. Well done by Nolan Helms. As number 8, well, next commands, P.S. And he's doing pretty well, alright. And in fact, he will move up to the lead of the 4th Super Chao. And that is going to do it as the last competitors make their way towards the finish line. Alright, so Nolan Helms beats out Jeff Nellis on the Battle of the Shortcut. Yep, and as he gets to number 5 victory, he improves above 500 for the season, and there's more something coming up when we come back. Do not go away! Okay, Paul, tell us who do we have next. Next up, we have Timothy P. Jackson, Ben Henderson, Charles Song Watson, and Raymond Hill. After securing an easy win for Raymond in last week's Week 13's race, we'll see how well these four chat will do in this week's edition. Let's look at the lineup, and it's best of luck to the next four superstars. As we load up the screen, there we are. The players' lineup remain to go. Everyone is on the clock, and let's have a challenge! Okay, the next four superstars are off and running, trying to impress their fans at home, trying to move one step closer towards coming back next season, or hopefully trying desperately to reach the playoffs this year. And right now, the four Chao are going to shake the palm trees to bring down that coconut-shaped fruit, and now they're going to eat the fruit, and there goes Raymond Hill. And look at that. I do believe he is going to have the upper hand on the four superstars for right now. Yep, Raymond Hill has got full control of the lead. But let's see how long his lead will last in the early run. As the first superstar to get speed first is number 2, who's trying desperately to catch up with the other Super Chao. And look who took a shortcut. Timothy P. Jackson and Charles Song Watson. Charles Song Watson's will have command of the lead. Timothy P. Jackson will have control of second place. As number 2, trying desperately to lead over the 4th Super Chao, opens this one up with back-to-back speed runs. And poor number 1 is singing the last place blues all the way in the back of the pack. He might need a couple of spears to get back in this one, but it's number 7 who will get the next command speed runs. And we have passed the 1 minute mark. As Charles Song Watson now has a little more breathing room ahead of Timothy P. Jackson. He is going to be the first to climb up the star wall. And let's find out who will get the next command on the speed bus. As Charles Song Watson enjoys a dominating lead. And that next PS will be made by Ben Henderson. And poor number 1. Yep, I do believe it's time for number 1 to get a couple of speed bus. If he wants to stay alive in the game, he is way behind the competition. Yep, he's going to need a couple of speed bus to get back in this one. And this is the first of them. Meanwhile, Timothy P. Jackson is trying his best to defend second place over Raymond Hill, but I don't think he's going to make a miracle comeback. There's no way he's going to make it. Next piece belongs to number 2, who leads over the 4th Super Chao with 4th place. That makes his first P. Bus of the race, and Charles Song Watson can say farewell to the competition in a hurry. He is going to get another easy victory here, folks, as Raymond Hill takes the next P months. Timothy P. Jackson, warm up, this is a catch up to Charles on Watson in time. Charles on Watson eats this out. Timothy P. Jackson for the midway. So Charles on Watson now has 6 wins up on his swing, and that's going to be followed by Timothy P. Jackson in second place. As number 7 will get number 10, that makes his second speed bus race. And coming in third place, we have Raymond Hill. And it looks like Ben Anderson will have to settle for 4th. And number 1 trying to catch up as he catches up with numbers 2 and 7. They are all getting left behind from the young competitors in a hurry. One of them has to get speed bus before the race is over. And number 2 will get that chance to make it his 4th speed bus. So, Charles R. Watson wins the battle over Timothy P. Jackson. That's right, Timothy P. Jackson, and there's more something coming up after we hear word from this. Race number 6 is up next, and who do we have again, Paul? It is Jason Hill, Kai Hugelson, Zach Orson, and Rusty Williamson. That is what we have for race number 6, a week 14's Meditation Action for Chao Racing 2020. And here we go. Let's send it down back to the M, of course. As the players get ready to blast off into action, everyone is on the clock. And let's rock this place! Here we go. Alright, so Zach Orson is trying his best to erase the memory of last week's tough loss. While the other 3 Chao are trying desperately to get wins on the board so that they, when they can come back next season. All Zach Orson really need wins on right so that he can have another chance to bring home a World Championship title. He made it to the World Championship 2 times in a row in 2019 and 2020. Find out the 4 Chao are going to be off and running, and as Zach Orson has 4 on a hill, may make it for the shortcut. It is Kai Hugelson, while next to Mass US. Good strategy by Zach Orson, trying to get another chance to reach the World Championship so that he'll try and make it the 3rd time a charm in the World Championship for 2021. And who will get Beavis number 2 in this race? It's number 8, who desperately has to catch up every now and then. Right now, though, it is number 7, who is way, way behind the competition behind number 8. Number 7 really needed some speedruns to get back in this one, but let's head back to number 8. That's a little bit more help than time with back-to-back speedruns. Right now, Rusty Williamson decided to pause for 1. So Kai Hugelson will have command in 2nd place. Jason will also have to push and move up a couple places. As the next PS we may buy, number 2, as we pass the 1-minute mark, take a look at the domination from Zach Orson. His fans watching from TVs and their computer webcams are surely happy with the results so far tonight and so far for the entire season. Let's hope he keeps it up for this race. Next PS belongs to number 1, the least of the 4 Silver Chao in 5th place. Poor number 7, meanwhile, is still stranded in last place. So it's number 8. But it's number 7 who is in dead meat all the way in the back of the pack trying to catch up with the crowd. I do believe it's time for number 7 to get some speed runs so that way he can catch up with the crowd for sure. But it's number 2 who will get number 10. That makes his second speed runs in the race. Oh well, Rusty Williamson is one of us, and so is Kai Hugelson. Well, Zach Orson is going to celebrate an easy victory over the competition for this race. No doubt about it. And number 1 can't forget about going to rest. He gets his second speed bus. And Zach Orson is going to celebrate once again. Zach Orson wins this one by a landslide. So now he is up to 12 wins for the season. As Jason Hill will get the next command speed bus. Right now, Kai Hugelson trying to finish this one up. I do believe Jason Hill is going to make the pass from Rusty Williamson to Quinn second place. Yep, so Rusty Williamson will come in third. And we have just enough time for one more speed battle on this base, and we may buy Kai Hugelson. And poor number 7 has no hope for surviving whatsoever. Zach Orson's on again. That's right, but how long was we last? We'll find out soon enough. Bang in a bit, do not go away. Well, we've seen 6 races so far for week 14's Men's Mission Action. Let's hear what Paul has to say about race number 7. Okay, but the start of the second half of our Men's Mission races, for race number 7, we have Rich Jennings, Michael Clayton, Thomas Linklater, and the GameStop Master Gary Dayton. Thomas Linklater trying to continue his run towards a 2021 championship season. Will it continue? We're about to find out right now. Please start the race! Alright, there goes Thomas Linklater, Aaron Jennings, Michael Creighton, and Gary Dayton. Thomas Linklater trying to stay alive in his hunt to become the 2021 world champion for Chao Racing Universe, while the other three Chao are trying desperately to get wins on the board, as always. And anything can happen, that's fine. Anything can happen in the Chao Racing Universe, as we always say, each and every week. Right now, Thomas Linklater has got Hakamehameha up in the front, and that will be followed by Michael Creighton in second place. Rich Jennings not too far behind in third place, and Thomas Linklater's gonna be heading for the water. As the first superstar against Peter to start the second half, it's Michael Creighton, who is trying to desperately to stay alive in the game over at the bridges. And Thomas Linklater has made it to the other side of the water real quickly. Number one is at the water, but I don't think he made it to the top of the hill. Nope. So Thomas Linklater is going to have command on the lead. As number two, who desperately trying to catch up, takes Bebus number two in this race. And take a look at poor number seven and poor number eight. These two Super Chao are battling neck to neck, but they're getting left behind in the competition all the way in the back of the pack. Who is going to get a chance to stay alive in the next BS? It's number 8, as we pass the 1 minute mark. So he'll gain the upper hand over number 7 for the count one. And there he is, Thomas Linklater has a commanding lead over Rich Jennings, who is currently battling with Michael Clinton for second place. Good strategy so far by Thomas Linklater, as the next BS win made by number one. Will we get some more help? We'll find out soon enough. Meanwhile, poor number seven and poor number eight are still battling for dear life. One of them has to get some speed rush if they want to catch up with the crowd and hurry, but back to number one. That's a little bit more help for number one. And right now, Thomas Linklater are trying his best to prevent Rich Jennings and Michael Creighton from making the pass as she reaches the top of the wall. What's going to happen next? We'll find out soon enough. As Thomas Linklater begins to make its way towards the home stretch. Next BS belongs to number 8. That makes it a second speed bus in the race. Oh, Rich Jennings wants some vengeance. He's trying his best to catch up with Thomas Linklater as they push the home stretch. But I think Thomas Linklater is going to have the upper hand. Yep, I don't think Rich Jennings is going to make a comeback here. No. As number 8 gets back to Max BS, that makes 2 in a row by 2 in a row. As Thomas Linklater makes his way towards the finish line, and he does it. Thomas Linklater gets his 12th win of his 2020 season. And that will be followed by Rich Jennings in second place. As number 7 finally gets the speed bus, but I think that's always going to get way tight race. He's going to be straight in last place. Yep, Rich Jennings will come in second, and it looks like Michael Creighton is going to come in third place. Oh well, they still had a great race, and we applaud for all the efforts they had for this week's action. As the last speed bus of this race will be made by number one, making his first speed bus of the race. So, Thomas Linklater is still tied with Zach Olsen for the best record. Yep, each one is 12-3 with an impressive victory, and we'll have more exciting action coming up. Do not go away! Alright, Paul, let's now sip one up race number 8. You bet, Brandon. It's the AC Gambler title, folks. Owen Warriors from the Warriors Brothers. Jose Gano from Mexico. And the great Lewis Charleston. So, after lots of training practice from the coaches, who is going to make the fans happy today? We're about to find out right now. Let's have the challenge! Okay, the next four competitors are off and running, and it looks like Woods Charleston is off to a very good start. And right now, number two is going to rest, and now number eight is going to rest. So these two Super Chao are going to be left behind in the competition for a while. Right now, the four competitors are going to eat the food, and it looks like Tyler, Lewis, and Jose are dancing to the beat. And there goes Owen Warriors, passing down the line, and number seven is going to rest. So Owen Warriors only has to deal with number one for the current moment. Owen Warriors will gain a little bit of ground in the early one, but here comes Tyler Fox and Lewis Charleston as Tyler Fox makes his way towards the water. And the first superstar to get speed bus is Jose Gano, who's also heading for the Wano in number 7, and number 2 at Chao 2, and look who paid off his shortcut! Tyler Fultz found the right angle to make it to the top of the hill! What a gamble that paid off wonderfully! As Owen Williams and the Bullies Brothers will have the right to secure speed by this number 2. Tyler Fultz now has a commanding lead over Jose Gano, who is trying to defend second place over number 2 and number 7. As Jose Gano leads the other 6 Chao with the next command speed, Tyler Fultz is showing making fans back in Atlantic City happy. And no matter where his fans in the US or anywhere around the world, Tyler Fultz is going to climb up the stone wall, trying to defend a huge lead. We have passed 1 minute, soon to be 1:10, as the next speed win made by Owen Williams. That makes his second speed buzz to the race, and number 1 is pausing for 1. And so is the great Lewis Johnson. So both of these Chao will be left behind the competition. Number 8 also taunts from 1. Number 1 really needs some help if he wants to get back in this one and hurry. But it's number 7 who will get the next command speed. And take a look at Tyler Fultz heading to the home stretch. Meanwhile, number 2 and number 7 are trying to handle Jose Gano and Owen Williams, with Lewis Johnson not too far behind from the pack. But this race is going to be all about Tyler Fultz tonight. Yep, next PS belongs to number 1. He finally gets some help, and I do believe he's going to move up a couple of places. Yep, and Tyler Fultz has made it to the finish line. As Lewis Johnson takes the next PS, you can tell him one off for Tyler Fultz. Atlantic City is showing happy with Tyler Fultz's incredible win, and again with that paying off for the shortcut over the top of the hill. So he wins this one by a landslide, as the next PS win made by Jose Gano. That makes it second speed buzz to the race. Number 1 is going to swim away from Lewis Johnson. Number 1 is expected to take second place, and now be followed by Lewis Johnson in third place. As number 8 will have the next command PS, and poor Owen Williams is battling with number 7, as the two Chao are just trying to finish up the race. They are getting left behind in competition, as the last speed bus will be made by Owen Williams, making his first speed bus to the race. How about that, Brandon? He found the right angle. Yep, and thus Tyler Fultz gets him a huge victory. Let's see if he'll keep it up next week. Coming up, we'll get more exciting action for you, but first, have a look at this. And welcome back. Now, still to come, we have our two-time returning champion, Adrian Ajeta, as he goes for his third and final Superstar Week honors in Week 14's main event. That's right, Brandon. But right now, let's proceed to race number 9, which will feature the 2018 Rising Stars champion Bryson Dawes, Eddie Warriors of the Warriors Brothers, TJ Edwards, or Terry Joe Edwards as his full name, and the license to drive Al E. Sr., a two-time world champion from 2012 and 2013. So, the players will line up and ready to go. Everyone is on the clock, and please start the race! Here we go, and Eddie Williams is going west. That will give Bryson Dawes, TJ Edwards, and Al Heen Sr. the opening edge. Let's find out which one of them will pay off or not in the early mine. Right now, these three Chao are going to shake the power trees, and they're going to bring down that coconut-shaped fruit. And now, they're going to eat the fruit. And there goes the 2018 Rising Stars champion, Bryson Dawes. And look at that. Bryson Dawes is going to have the upper hand of the four superstars, because Al Heen Sr. and TJ Edwards are both dancing to the beat. So it's all about Bryson Dawes for a moment. But we'll see how long his lead will last. As the first superstar to get his beat bus is number 1, who is flying over at the one along with Al Heen Sr. and TJ Edwards. And here comes number 2, trying to catch up, and someone has took a shortcut! I do believe it's going to be Eddie Williams who got the shortcut strategy done! Yep, by the way, looks at it, as 2018 My Stars Champion Rising Stars takes CBS number 2, it is indeed Eddie Williams who went the rest of the start of the race, now has command of the lead thanks to a shortcut! And we are approaching 1 minute mark in just a couple of moments from now. Eddie Williams trying to get back on track after forcing to take a nap at the start of the race, as the next PS win made by number 2, who desperately needs to catch up every now and then, trying to lead number 8 at us. By now, it is TJ Edwards, who has come in of second place ahead of Bryson Dorns and Alvin Sr. TJ Edwards trying to make a comeback in the early one. We'll soon know if he'll have enough distance to make the pass. Next BS belongs to number 8, who is stranded in last place behind the pack. Meanwhile, Bryson Dorns is in trouble. He had the lead early on, but now he gave way the lead to Eddie Warriors. And the second place to TJ Edwards. Alvin Sr. also doing his best to stay alive in the game. As number 2 will get another turn, that makes his second speed burst of the race. And Eddie Warriors is safely out the home stretch with no opponents to worry about. He is going to get another 5-3, which will make his 7th win of his 2020 season. As the last is to drive, Alvin Sr. gets the next command BS. Yep, Eddie Warriors is gone, ladies and gentlemen. No one is going to catch up to him in time. Eddie Warriors wins this one after forcing the goal mess at the start of the race. And Bryson Dorns will get his second speed bus. So despite snoozing at the beginning of the race, Eddie Warriors paid off a shortcut strategy to move up to 7 wins this week. As number 2 will get another speed bus, but he and number 8 have no hope for surviving whatsoever. Good race, everybody, and congratulations to Eddie Warriors. That's right, that's lucky number win number 7 for Eddie Warriors of the Warriors Brothers tonight. And we'll find out who will prevail in this next race right after we present word from this. Okay, moving right along to race number 10. Race number 10 is between Chip Sube, Bobby K, Benny Mowen, and Steven Robinson. Congratulations to Bobby K for winning last week's race. Now let's see how well these four Chao will fare in this week's week 14th action. Everyone is on the clock, and good luck to the next four superstars. Let's rock this place! Okay, here comes Chip, Bobby, Benny, and Steven, all making their way through the rainbow path, better known as the starting gates of this lovely Chao Racing Virtual Stadium. And right now they are at the palm trees, and from there they're going to bring down their coconut shaped fruit, and now they're going to eat the fruit. And there goes Benny Mowen busting down the line, and he and Steven Robinson are both going to rest. That means Bobby K will have command of the lead, and Chip Sube will have control of second place. As number 7, who immediately wakes up from his sleep, takes the opening toss for his face, Bobby K and Chip Sube are both making their way towards the water, trying to maintain a huge lead for the current moment. As the superstar to get speed burst number 2 is number 8, and I think one of them has took a shortcut. It's the cowboy, Benny Mowen! He took a nap, and now he made it to the top of the hill. He now takes a back-taking shortcut, going for his 4th win of his 2020 season, even though much of the season was lacking this affair. Anyway, he's doing a pretty good job in this race, I can tell you that, as the next BS we made by Chip Sube, who goes in 3rd place behind Bobby K, and number 8 is getting pissed off. He is getting left behind in the competition. And he talks for one as we pass the 1 minute mark of this exciting race. And who will get the next command speed bus? It's Steven Robinson, who currently has 7 wins among his lead. And right now, it is Benny Mowen, who has a commanding lead over Bobby K. He is going to be climbing up the stone wall. Let's see if he can hold on to the lead. Next BS belongs to number 1, who desperately needs to catch up every now and then. Poor number 2 and poor number 8, meanwhile, are battling neck to neck for a two-eye behind number 1. Number 2 and number 8 are both trying their best to catch up to the crowd. I believe one of them should get a speed bus to get up, pick up back of this one for sure. But back to number 1. That's back-to-back speed bus for number 1 as he catches up with number 7. Meanwhile, Benny Mowen still trying to defend a huge lead over Bobby K. He is the first to approach the home stretch, the movie portion of this MO course. And he's doing a pretty good job so far. As number 7 will get his second speed bus, he got over it that time. And yes, Benny Mowen is going to celebrate the victory this afternoon. The cowboy Benny Mowen does it again. That's his 4th win of his 2020 season. Great job from rebounding from his losses he suffered before. And that's going to be followed by Bobby K in second place. as number one will get his first B-Best, and that is squared away. Steven Robinson comes in third place, and number eight can just forget about this place as the race comes to a close. Alright, congratulations to Benny Moen. Yep, his fans are making him proud today. Let's find out how well he'll do next week. Back in a bit, do not go away! Okay, we're back from our commercial break, and we got only a couple more races left for the men's mission portion this week. That's right, the first of the remaining races will feature J.J. Nehemiah, Michelle Atwell Ed Crosby, Orlando Alvesta, and from one half of the defending tag team champions, Police Joey, K.C. Richardson. Keep Kayla to be exact. Let's find out who will get the win this week. Everyone is on the clock, and please start the race! So while Adrian Legend prepares to attempt for a third and final Superstar Week victory in the main event, these four champs will participate in race number 11. And right now they're at the other side of the rainbow path, and now they make their way towards the palm trees. And once they get there, they're going to shake the palm trees to bring down that coconut shaped fruit, and now they're going to eat the fruit. And there goes Orlando Armesta and J.J. Nehemiah. These two channels are going to be bowing for the lead up in the front. And let's find out who will get the first speed bars of race number 11 this week. As Orlando and JJ head for the water, it's going to be number 8 who will get the first speed bars as he quickly wakes up from his rest. Number 2 is going to rest, so he will have to join number 7 for dear life. Number 2 and number 7 are already getting lapped behind that come the competition. And number 7 is going to be heading for the water trying to gain some ground. As the superstar to get speed bus number 2 of race number 11 is J.J. Nehemiah, who is catching up to our leader, Orlando Armesta. Orlando and J.J. are making their way towards the top of the hill, and once they pass the flags, they're going to reach the sapphire portion of Nemo course. As the next speed bus we made by number 2, who desperately needs to catch up right now and then. Right now, Casey Richardson is battling with Eric Crosby for third place. Behind Orlando and JJ, we have passed the 1 minute mark. Good race so far by these competitors, let's hope they keep it up as we head back into number 2. That's back to back speed for number 2. He is currently leaving numbers 1 and 8 in the dust. Take a look at poor number 1. He is getting stranded in last place behind number 8 and number 2. I don't think we'll get any of any now. Who got the next speed bus? It's the Chao Outlaw Eric Crosby. And look at this. Orlando Armesta has scored a mess, so J.J. Nehemiah is going to have command of the lead. Eric Crosby will have to push a battle with J.J. and Orlando for the lead up at the front. And here comes Casey, which is in front of police, Joey, with the next command spear. And poor number 1 is still singing the last place blues. I don't think he or number 8 will get any help for the crowd at all. Nope, not when he looks at it. Next spear belongs to Eric Crosby. That makes sense, second spear race. And uh-oh, he's trying to make a statement here. He's making the pass from Orlando Armesta. All four are challenging, making the way towards home stretch to come with. And I do believe Eric Crosby is going to get the job done for his Canadian fans once again. As number 2, Boss Moon, takes a first few rest, trying to pull this one away with a force of a child. And Eric Crosby is going to celebrate to his Canadian fans watching from home. The Chao Outlaw Eric Crosby gets number 5 victory. He's up to 7 wins with that victory this afternoon. As number 2 will indeed pull this one away from the 4 Super Chow. As he spent the course for now with Bad Direct VS. That makes a total of 4 speed buzz for number 2. And the Chao Outlaw Eric Crosby now has 7 wins. That's right, congratulations to Eric Crosby. Back for the main event after this commercial break. Stay tuned. Alright, and Paul. What time is it? Well, Brandon, it's main event time! And this week we have our two-time returning champion, Adrian Regina, all pumped up and ready to go for another exciting main event. Today, for week 14's main event action, his challengers are Gray Pickersfield, one of the fastest wonders of the fall half of the season, our defending world champion, Luke Green, and Kevin Forrester, one of the newcomers who's doing pretty well, by the way, looks like. Yep, he's doing quite well. Anyway, Adrian Legenda took home the last two individual main event victories. Who is going to prevail in this one? We're about to find out right now. Let's rock this place! Alright, so this week's main event is brought to you by Pepsi. A soft drink that always quenches your thirst and helps you always think young. Pepsi, the choice of every generation. And right now, Greg Biggersfield is going to eat the fruit. And there he goes. He is going to have coming on the lead. And right now, Adrian and Jenna and the other two channels are going to eat the fruit right now. And there goes Adrian and Jenna, our returning champion, who is going to have second place over our defending world champion, Luke Green. And it looks like Adrian and Jenna is going to be heading for the water. And so is Luke Green and Kevin Forrester. As the first superstar against B-Bus on week 14's main event presented by Pepsi Soft Drinks is the fast runner Greg Biggersfield. But hold everything, look who's blowing Greg Biggersfield's speed. It's our defending world champion. Luke Green found the right angle and he made it past the shortcut. He made it to the top of the hill, so now he will have command of the lead. As Kevin Forrester will take B-Bus number 2 in this race, currently sitting in 4th place. Greg Biggersfield is once again shot. He is the one of the fastest runners in the league, but now he might have a long way to go if he wants to catch up to our current leader, Luke Green. Will Greg Biggersfield ever have a chance to gain wins for the season? We'll soon know, as the next BS we made by number 2. And we have passed the 1 minute mark in this race. Meanwhile, it is on returning champion, Adrian Jenna, who currently sitting in 3rd place. Oh well, let's just say his last 2 main events were a good one and a toughie. Anyway, number 2 gets back-to-back speedruns, now getting a little bit more room ahead of number 7, and take a look at poor number 1. He passes from 1, so now he will have to join number 8. Both number 1 and number 8 are trying desperately to catch up with the other 6 competitors in a hurry, and down goes number 1 for the count. That's going to cost the same damage. And who got the next one? It's number 7, trying to catch up with number 2 again. Luke Green and Greg Biggersfield are heading for a home stretch. I don't think Greg Biggersfield is going to have a chance to make the pass from Luke Green. Nope. Next BS belongs to number 8. Yep, Luke Green is going to be the new superstar of the week. Greg Biggersfield will not have enough distance to catch up to him in time. As Kevin Forrester takes his second speedrun, Luke Green wins week 14th main event over Greg Biggersfield. So Luke Green is the new superstar of the week for the Chao Racing Universe. And we have just enough time for one more speedrun of this week's exciting main event. And it will be made by number 8, making his second speedrun of the race. So congratulations to Luke Green, who is on week 14th superstar of the week for Chao Racing 2020. That's right. Coming up, we'll present our 8 races for the women's division portion of the show. But first, have a look at this.